My name is Razwan from the University of Law. Working here, and I'm doing my PhD in the University of Algarve as a candidate from the Erasmus student. So now I'm working with my two supervisors, Professor Pedro Guerreiro from the University of Algarve and Professor Gustavo from OUNL. So I'm talking about federations of online labs for assisting engineering and science education in the MENA region. So the structure of this one is complexa, relations, state of arts, problem statement, research objective, research approach and methodology, result, data and validate, dissertation states, and current and expected contribution. So let me talk about the MENA region. Where is the MENA region? MENA region is covered between from Iran, tomorrow. Many people till now doesn't know the terms of what's meaning MENA region. So what is the country from Iran to Morocco and the Arab world and then Maghrebian country? So education in the MENA regions is taking the three types. There's the French education, our English education, and some countries using the Arab education system. But there is several cores now available in the MENA region. This is the short history about the MENA region education system in the French and English. And now there is several international university branches open in the MENA regions. For example, New York University in the United Arab Emirates, and Guardian Medium, Medium University of Canada. From this course, and from this several branch universities opening there, there is some challenge still have in education system in the MENA region. For example, the education system is not the quality of education system in the MENA region still not unequal. So you see, maybe you find some country in the MENA region have a good quality of education, another country have a low quality of education. It is not equal yet. So, and other things is unemployment people. There's many unemployment people now, maybe because of this lack of education system. Many study, our many reported, proposed many things to develop this education system. For example, how it's working for how can to develop education system in some study say, okay, we can start developing student skills. Another say, okay, let you say doing some operations work among researcher, teacher, and student. Our another study is allowed to use in the modern technology that's available now. So, the EU is MENA region. We are starting to study MENA regions and education region, but first we are taking state of arts. We are doing some literature review about the MENA region by planning the review and then conducting the review and reporting the lesson, reporting the review to find the result. During the study, the review from the MENA region, so we found that in the education system, there is many technology can help education system. For example, web technology now is available. Web technology can increase the interactions and help to making some a lot of collaboration work and have a positive impact in education as well. Another part we are going directly in the online learning and online labs. We are talking about online learning. Online learning means offering different course and supervisive learning for education students and increasing the collaboration work. More is about online labs. Online labs is parts of field technology. So there is limitations of labs, a useful alternative in case if you don't have hands-on lab. It will be useful for students using online lab. And one of example that is a good example to take for online lab is VZR. VZR is short terms or virtual instrument system in reality. There is no more time to talk about VZR. So, the problem statement during our study education system, the MENA region, we found some problem there. For example, they still not adapted the education system with the new technology. And one of the reports say that quality of primary education in the MENA region is still below the standard of developing nations. And another report say MENA countries can learn through the best practice and so on. Comparative quality and capacity of workers and innovated or adapted new technology like strong collaboration work which would allow them to share experience, idea and resource. So from this study, our research questions will be why the collaboration or cooperation in the MENA region is weak. Weak, especially in the sector of engineering and science field in higher education. So this is the main research question for us. So our research objectives will be help to characterize the higher education system in the MENA region, especially in this field, engineering and science, and another to find and determine the degree of collaboration and cooperation in the MENA around online labs. And third, to start to create a federation lab for serving the MENA region people, especially for researcher, teacher, and student. Our methodology. Take time to study world, so it started to evaluate and measure objectives and pairs to evaluate and data collection methods. This is the important part for us to find our research questions, data collection method. So the analysis and reporting the result and finally implement the solution. So you can read the paper if you go to more details. Already explained. So, the result from doing my PhD, this is some date, event, names and event place, and what I get the result from this event. The first one is 2013. It was one of conference called EduCom. It's one of the main conference in remote lab and education system. So it was in the Berlin. In this conference, I met some researcher. One of researchers was Mr. Raoul. I meet him there. So, and another people from the MENA regions who wanted to be interested to using on a lab. Another conference was in the Morocco. Marrakesh was also 2013. And the important conference was, for me, was Reef Conference. It's held in Israel. This is that helped me to understand what is meaning online laboratory, especially Israel, that's why I'm working now with it this time. So this is the important conference. So it's helped me so much. I meet the main people who's working with the Israel, people with the main researcher. So, this also I published a paper, read, served in the local organization community, and review paper. It's also And after study, the data collection methods, I'm using and collect many data from it, from paper, from REEF, EduComs, and AGOE journals. I published another contribution this way. This is find, this proved my research question, this paper. And the last one is 2015 was EduLearn conference, was in Holland, in Barcelona. And another one is already done, published in Easter, but it will be a virtual presentation. This is the short activity that I did during my PhD lab. So, dissertation studies. So I'm working with these three directions. One of study reserve, another to make online lab federations, and the third direction is a community of practice around online lab. So we can go there. So the direction one is the study visa. It is almost done, this work. So I'm studying why I selected visa. You know, visa is a word as the best remote lab in 2015. The best remote lab. So it is good to decide already in my hand, so I can offer this tools for the people. It's free, and I'm working now with the development visa and the study activity visa. That's proven. The visa is a good example to show the people to using the remote lab. And now new studies virtual system by using UML diagram. This is for. It's more for a new researcher who don't have a complete idea about visa. They can show him by visual. Yeah. Direction two, it's around 65 to 70 percentage is done, is making online federations by create a new node of visa. It will be support 8 language, this new node. 8 language is in the model of Arabic and Kurdish, my home language is home Kurdish language, so it will be 8 language. So, but we still have waiting one of PAPT. That's why it's 17%. Another one, direction 3, is committee of practice around online lab. This is that will be shared. This experiment will be shared between two universities. From the MENA, this one. So still now we are doing some experiment for the MENA people, for researcher, for student, for university, and we're trying to share this experiment now around them, between them. This is almost 35 to 40% is done, but it's needed more work. So current and expected contributions. Where do ideas come from? To reach the goal, we have some using some of the wise and edge ideas. Why, how, what, where, when, how. So why does the higher education system in the MENA region need to reach it? Because it's not equal yet, it's needed to support more. And how can the system, higher education system in the MENA region by sharing experiment? So when will the regions to able to share to reshaping their educations? And when must you start into using the new technology? What the time? This is a good time now, especially with this new tools, free tools. And what kind of technology? We are selected as the online laboratories technology using, good technology. And who is going to benefit from use online laboratory? It is be benefit from higher education, teachers, students, people is living in the education environment. So expected contribution. We are expecting our goal is going to be students are performing more experiments relevant to their field of study, especially of the science of an engineering study. And why it's on a lab? Because almost people agree, our research or activity people with the UE technology agree that online lab is the safe time and save money. Because if you compare with creating a new lab with the new technology, it's be very expensive. So if you don't have this money, so what I have to do? I have to find another solution. So okay, online lab is a good solution, at least this time to save money. And this is the online lab, allows students to develop a technical skills. This is very important that students will be have a good skills for future and for jobs and contribute the quality of higher education in the MENA. This is maybe will go make the higher education in the MENA regions more high quality. So why online lab federations? Because it can help to improve education by using online lab, it will be improved, I hope so. So community of practice, why we are going to make it a community practice? Because we need to share this experiment and resource, and we are make the collaboration, our collaboration more strong among these people from the middle. So finally of the work, the goal, all of these goals, it's are maybe simple, but we are believe it will be up to us. Thank you for your attention.